focused on Porto, where suburban trains ran an extremely frequent service, morning and evening times in particular, in and out of Trindade Terminus. Part of the way it was even double track, where trains had a nifty turn of speed. In the late 1960s, early 70s, Trindade station in the evening was at least 90% steam, with trains coming in and out every few minutes, headed by 260 tanks, which were in the minority, 0440 Malay tanks with gleaming copper cap chimneys, and Henschel 282 tanks, big enough for the standard gauge, let alone a meter gauge railway. Most had to be coaled, watered, and turned before going out again. The 440 Malays in particular were pretty little machines, just right somehow for a narrow gauge railway. They looked right, worked right, and were there in abundance. Like all Portuguese substandard gauge locos, they carried the E prefix before their numbers, in this case at the base of their chimneys. Coaching stock was comfortable bogies, well suited to commuter trains, and the rail cars, modern, often running in tandem. Faster and quicker off the mark than the steam services, they naturally carried less people, which gave them a disadvantage in the high loading peak hour periods, but a distinct advantage operationally. The livery was dark blue, corresponding to that of the newer bogey stock. They were two-man operated, a driver and a traveling conductor to act as guard and ticket inspector. The Henschel 282 tanks, like so many of the Portuguese meter gauge engines, all had copper cap chimneys, again with their number plates on the sides. To see one waiting at the platform end was to realize that this was a real railway. Station work was fast. No sooner was the train emptied of passengers than the engine was unhooked, ran round the train and drifted back into the servicing area adjacent to the tunnel under the city. Whilst neat 0440 tanks run in and out with their trains, one of these engines remains a station pilot. These engines are relatively elderly, dating from 1905, whereas the smoke-deflected Henschel 282 tanks were built in 1931. But the most elderly are the 260 tanks, some of them going back to 1886 with copper-capped bell mounts. They come from a variety of builders, Decauville, Kessler, Orenstein and Koppel, and Esslingen. All of them are maintained and overhauled at the Boa Vista workshops between Trindade Station and the junction of Senhora da Hora at the end of a double-track section. The standard of cleanliness is good, difficult sometimes on the busy Porto lines, but like the whole of Portugal's railway system, everything appears to be excellently maintained. Henschel tank number plate on chimney and works plate on tank side has had its quick service. Another 0440 Malay tank has been released from its train and a new cycle of events begins. The 282 tank begins its maneuvers to run down onto its train. No trouble running bunker first with this commodious cab. And within a few minutes, they're away with a quick shrill whistle before diving into the tunnel for the climb up the steeply graded double track to Senhora da Hora. Its first stop en route to Pavoa de Varzim. Henschels did well on these narrow gauge lines in Portugal, building not only the 282 tanks, but also the 0440 Malays. And as we shall now see, an improbable and also compound 2460 tank, which works the Corgo line up from the Douro Valley.